Yeah.
So shall we start the meeting now?
Yeah, we can. Yes. Everybody is on mute.
Yeah. Good evening, everybody. I welcome you all for this virtual meeting today that we are going to have on the series of Vijayanagar temples that are seen in Tamil Nadu. In today's topic of lecture, we will be seeing about two very important temples that are constructed by the Vijayanagar kings, an outstanding architecture of the Vijayanagar period that can be seen in these two temples of Sri Mushnam and the Ramaswamy temple at Kumbakonam. So today, in our series of temples, of Vijayanagar temples, we will be seeing about Sri Mushnam and the Ramaswamy temple at Kumbakonam. Bhuvaraha Swami temple of Sri Mushnam is located in Cuddalore district of Tamil Nadu. The temple is dedicated to Varaha Swami, the boar avatara of Mahavishnu. He's called as Bhuvaraha Swami. And his consort is Bhudevi, and she is known as Ambujavalli Thayar in this temple. This is a beautiful temple dedicated to Varaha, the one and only one of its kind of those ancient period, now in the state of Tamil Nadu. This is the beautiful Rajagopuram and the entrance of the temple that you see in this photograph. You have a Nalukal huge mandapam in front of the Rajagopuram, and there's a big Dvajastambam or Deepastambam. It's not Dvajastambam, it is Deepastambam. Normally in temples of Tamil Nadu, you do not have these Deepastambams, but Deepastambams are seen in all the Kongu Nadu temples. But in this belt, there's only temple that you could see this such a beautiful Deepastambam. In Karnataka, such temple, the Deepastambams are there. And on top of that, you'll find the Garuda image there, and they call it as Garudastambam also in Karnataka. So this is the beautiful entrance of the great Bhuvaraha Swami temple at Sri Mushnam, located in the Cuddalore district of Tamil Nadu. The temple is a very old temple which had been existing from a very, very long time. The Cholas of the 10th century had made a lot of expansion and made it as a structural temple with granite stones and built beautiful prakaras in this temple. The later expansion of this beautiful temple of Bhuvaraha into an architectural marvel was done by the Nayaks of the Tanjavur, especially the Achyutappa Nayakar and his son Raghunath Nayakar and his brother-in-law were responsible for renovating this wonderful temple into a very beautiful architectural marvel that can speak about the greatness of the Vijayanagar Empire. The granite wall of this temple, built by the Cholas, surround the temple, enclosed, and the whole temple complex encloses many shrines and the temple tank also inside this complex. The Rajagopuram is huge, a seven-tiered Rajagopuram, seven-storied Rajagopuram, Yedu Nilai Rajagopuram, they call it in Tamil. And it's a beautiful structure that is built during the Nayak time. What you see here in this picture is the Moolamurti, the Bhuvaraha Swami of this temple at Sri Mushnam. The temple is dedicated to Varaha Avatar of Vishnu. The demon Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha, stole the mother earth, Bhudevi, the consort of Vishnu, and he went into the Padala Loka. Mahavishnu took the form of boar, Varaha Avatara, went inside, and he saved Bhumidevi from the clutches of Hiranyaksha and brought her back to this. So this is the avatar, Varaha Avatar of Mahavishnu. He killed the demon. The sweat of the demon dropped here, creating a big pond. And that is the temple tank that you see here. The Pushkarini of the Varaha Swami at Sri Mushnam is made out of the sweat that fell from Hiranyaksha. When Varaha killed the Hiranyaksha, Hiranyaksha had a dying wish. He requested the king, he requested Vishnu that he should look onto him so that he gets moksha. So Vishnu turned towards the direction of the dying Hiranyaksha to see him. And that's why the central image in the sanctum is facing south. And the body of the Vishnu in the Varaha Avatara is facing the devotees, which is onto the west side. This is a beautiful west-facing temple. This is again the Moolamurti, Varaha Swami at the Sri Mushnam temple. You can see the beautiful Prabha Mandala around him. And look at the way he stands there with his two hands on his hip, standing majestically with the head slightly tilted up and looking to the south side. This temple is considered as one of the Swayambhu Kshetram. In Vaishnava language, they call it Swayambhakta Kshetram. Swayambhu Kshetrams of Vishnu, where the presiding deity is believed to have manifested by himself and not as a pradishta done by somebody else. So this is one of the Swayambhakta Kshetram or Swayambhu Kshetrams of Vishnu. We have 8 such Swayambhu Kshetrams in this country. Srirangam, Ranganatha is one of the Swayambhu Murtis. Tirumala, Venkatramana is again a Swayambhu Murti. Sri Mushnam, Varaha is a Swayambhu Murti. And similarly, the Vanamamalai, Totatri, he is also a Swayambhu Murti. These are the 4 Kshetras, Swayambhu Kshetras that you find in the southern part of India. And in the northern part of India, you have Shaligrama, that is the Nepal, Naimicharanya, Pushkara, and Badrikashrama. All these are also the Swayambhu Kshetrams of Mahavishnu, where Mahavishnu had self-manifested himself, and it is not as a Pradishta Murti. You have to note this, wonderful temple of Varaha, Bhu Varaha Swami in Sri Mushnam, is not one among the Divya Desams. You have 108 Divya Desams of Vishnu spread over the country, but this is not one among the Divya Desams, but it's an Abhimana Sthalam, a very great or a very important place of Vishnu is considered to be Sri Mushnam. When you go to Tirumala, Tirumala is known as Varaha Kshetram. The Varaha Swami there, who is residing by the Pushkarini, gave the place for Lord Venkateshwara to stay in Tirumala. So every day, we go there, whenever any pilgrim goes to Tirupati, he first has the darshan of Varaha Swami and then only the Lord Venkateshwara darshan. But, and all the pujas are first offered to Varaha Swami, the Nivedyams are first offered to Varaha Swami and then only to Lord Venkateshwara in Tirumala. So in this place of Sri Mushnam also, the practice is continued in the other way. There is a small temple or a small shrine for Venkateshwara, which is located inside the Gopuram. Unlike the other places, it is not somewhere in the ground, but this Venkateshwara shrine is located inside the Gopuram. And there are small narrow steps that lead up to the Gopuram. People who come to this temple first go up to Venkateshwara, take his blessings, come down, and then only go to see Varaha Swami. Similarly, people who are not able to climb up and go there, the 2 padams of Venkateshwara are kept right in front of the Rajagopuram, where they can make their prayers to these padam and proceed to have the darshan of Bhu Varaha Swami there. So this is a very important feature that this temple alone has here in Tamil Nadu. And apart from this, one other rare feature is that the Saptamatrikas, which are normally found in the temples of Shiva, is found here in this Vishnu temple also. Saptamatrikas have a beautiful temple dedicated for them in the complex of this Bhuvaraha Swami temple at Srimurtha, which we will see them later. Now, this is the artistic representation of the Bhuvaraha Swami in the Mulasthana of the temple. Now, you see here, the Bhuvaraha is standing with his two arms kept on his hip and looking towards the south side. The Mulasthana is made of Shaligrama Shila. It is a Shaligrama Shila. And it's a very, very small murti, and it's only about 2 feet in height. The Mulamurti is a very small one, and it's only 2 feet in height, and that is kept on a very highly raised pedestal. A beautiful Shaligrama Shila. It shines like gold. It's a beautiful Shaligrama Shila of Varahamurti that is there in the Mulasthana. He's seen with his two arms kept in the hip. The Shankha and the Chakra, which is normally adorned on the upper hands of Vishnu. Here the two upper hands are missing, but here, as Varaha who's holding his hand on the hip, he also holds the Shankha and Chakra with him on this hip. It's a very, very rare feature that you see here. And this Varaha Murti is always adorned with the Shaligrama Mala. The Shaligrama Mala, which is normally seen in all the Vishnu temples adorning the Vishnu Murti, Mula Murti, is also seen here. Huge Shaligramas are made as a big mala, and that mala is always there on this Varaha Murti. The idol is seen facing south, with his head turned totally to the south side. And very small images of Sri Devi and Bhudevi are seen on the either side. When you go there to the temple to have a darshan of this, normally you can never see the Sri Devi and Bhudevi murtis unless and otherwise you happen to witness the Abhishega time. Otherwise, these are always covered with flowers and the dresses of Varaha Murti. So the Sri Devi and Bhudevi, very small images of them are on the either side of this Varaha Murti. Pancharatra Agama worship is followed in this temple, and pujas are performed in this temple according to the Tenkalai Sampradayam of the Sri Vaishnavas. The Vadakalai Vaishnavas, who normally are dissociated in Tenkalai temples, are also given importance in this temple, along with the Madhva Brahmins. They are also people who participate in all the rituals of the temple. This temple is very unique for the Madhva community also. So all the two sects, Vadakalai, Tenkalai, and the Madhva Brahmins, all the three of them participate in the rituals of this particular temple of Sri Bhuvaraha Swami at Sri Mushna. The Utsav Murti is not in Varaha Murti, but it's not a Varaha Murti, but it's the regular Vishnu with the Shankha Chakra, Abhayahasta, and Gada in his hand. And he is seen with his two consorts, Sri Devi and Bhudevi. He is called as Yajna Varaha. This Yajna Varaha is the beautiful Rupam of Mahavishnu. And why this beautiful Rupam of Mahavishnu stands as the Utsav Murti is because Bhudevi wanted him to see his Vishnu in the beautiful Rupam of the regular thing with Shankha and Chakra. To bless Bhudevi, he is seen as the regular form of Yajna Varaha in this temple. There's a legend which goes with this temple. There was a local Nawab of this area. He was ailing with a carbuncle, and doctors gave him a lot of treatment. And he believed it was incurable. The doctors gave up their hopes, and he started praying Bhuvaraha. And Bhuvaraha cured him of all his ailments. From that time onwards, This Nawab made generous contributions to this temple, and he himself got later named as Bura Sahib. And this Muslim association is very much there in this particular temple of Sri Mushna. This is the Yajna Varaha seen on the mount of Surya Prabha during the Brahmotsava. Every year, the deity of Sri Varaha, that is Yajna Varaha Swami, during the Brahmotsava time, is taken to a distant village where these Muslims hail from. That village is called Killai. It is very close to Chidambaram. It's about 45 kilometers from Sri Mushna. The god is carried there the entire day, 2 days. They walk up to that place and Killai, they say. They go and halt at that place. It's a fishing village. And it's completely populated with Muslim community. All the Muslim community are descendants of these Nawab. They make their offerings to the god. They offer lots of dry fruits, flowers, garlands, everything to this, and good vastrams to this god. And all these are accepted by Varaha Swami. And Varaha Swami in turn gives them all those prasadams. And they take this prasadam to their mosque, pray it there, and then consume it. So this is a practice which is going in Killai even today. And as a gesture of this Nawab, during the Rathotsavam of this temple festival, the flag that is hoisted on top of the Ratham is made by this Muslim community and is given to them. And every year, the Muslim goes up the top of the Ratham and hoists the flag there for this Varaha Swami's chariot during the Brahmotsavam. This is the beauty of this great Sri Mushnam Adi Varaha Swami. Since this Moolamurti is said to be Saligrama, the 6 Kala Pujas, Abhishekams are performed to this Moolamurti. In fact, to the best of my knowledge, I would say this is the only place where the 6 Kala Pujas, Abhishekams are performed to the Moolamurti. Most of the Vaishnava temples, the Perumal image is so huge that the Abhishekams are not performed every day. They may be performing it in once in a week or once in 15 days or once in a year or something like that. And some places it is made of stucco when only Tailakapu is applied and things like that. But here, since this is a Saligrama Sila, 6 Abhishekams are performed to this Varahamurti every day. And it's a beautiful sight to watch this wonderful Saligrama Sila being given the celestial bath during the 6 Kala Pujas. When this Abhishekams are performed, Purusha Sukta and other Vedic chants are recited from the Mantava outside. This is chanted by the both the sects of Vaishnavites and the Madhva Brahmins also. The Madhva Brahmin community is a huge community that is there around this area, and they think this Varaha Swami is their Kuladevata, and they come to this temple every day, and this group of Madhva Mutts also established here, and representatives from there come and chant the Purusha Sukta and other Vedic chants during the Abhishekas every day for this Varaha Swami. And these Madhvas are also given a privilege of chanting the Madhva Purana and the Gajendra Moksha Patlam during the pujas on specific occasions during this festivals of this temple. The shrines of Thayar Ambujavalli, there's a separate shrine for this Thayar Ambujavalli. Then again, a separate shrine for Srinivasa Perumal, Venugopal Swami, Rama, and there's a special sannidhi for Kulandayamman. This devi is made of stucco, and there's a separate shrine for that. It's called Kulandayamman. A devi is seen with a baby in the hand. And a lot of people come here and pray for them to get a child or anything. So this, when they come and pray here, I think, I believe that their wish is fulfilled. And this Kurundayaman Sannidhi is very, very popular in this Bhuvaraga Swami temple. In that Sannidhi, you also have the Saptamatrikas. These Saptamatrika temples and this Kurundayaman Sannidhi are managed by one particular community of Mudaliar people. The pujas, everything is offered only by the Mudaliar community there. And this is the unique feature of this particular temple. Apart from all these shrines, you have the shrines for Ramanujacharya, Manavala Manmunigal, and so many other Vaishnavite Acharyas are there. And also, some of the Brindavans of the Madhva Acharyas are seen inside the temple complex. The Brindavans are the place where the Acharyas of the Madhva sect are kept in, this is the Samadhi of them. Thing is converted in Brindavan, and many such Brindavans are there inside this temple complex. This is the beautiful temple complex of Bhuvaraga Swami. You have the shrine of the Bhuvaraga Swami here and the Rajagopuram, and you have a Gopuram on the north side. This again, the north side Gopuram is not open for public on all days, and that is used as a Vaikuntha Vakili. That is, on Vaikuntha Ekadasi day alone, they open it as Surgavasan. The temple has been in existence from 10th century. The inscriptions from this temple and the Shiva temple nearby contribute a lot of information about the grants of the Cholas that been done during the Chola era for this temple. Inscriptions of Veera Rajendra of 1063, Kulotunga of 1070 to 1120, talk about a lot of gifts of villages to this particular temple. The inscription, there is also an inscription of Virupaksha II of Vijayanagara king of 1471 in this temple, making a lot of grants to this temple. This temple saw the major expansions during the time of Achyutappanayaka, that is during 1560 to 1614. That included the Rajagopuram, the plain beautiful mantapas, especially the Purushasukta Mantapa, the Prakaras, the other small shrines, and they also donated liberally in gold and silver, form of jewels and vessels, lands for regular conduct of pujas and festivals in this beautiful temple. This is the beautiful Rajagopuram, seven-tiered Rajagopuram of the temple. This temple, Rajagopuram, is total granite structure at the base. As it goes up, it's a brick structure, brick mortar structure, right up to the top. It's a beautiful structure that was built in the 16th century. Look at the base, granite base of this wonderful Rajagopuram, a beautiful granite base with intricate, artistic, and wonderful execution of the patterns there. Look at the base. You have a koshtas, different koshtas, the Kumbha Pancharas. The Adhishtana is so beautifully molded in different levels, and it raises up to almost about 12 feet or 15 feet high. And then from there, the brick structure starts. Inside the brick structure is what you find the temple of Venkateshwara there. If you see there, inside the brick structure, this is the granite structure. Very beautiful, very intricately done granite structure. The entrance opening of this temple, the gateway of this temple, Rajagopuram. Look at that. On either side, you have these two ladies there. They represent Ganga and Yamuna, and these two are supposed to be the gatekeepers in all the temples. And here you find Ganga and Yamuna here in a beautiful form. Look at this. This is Ganga. She's standing on a Makara. Why I say it's Ganga? It's because she's standing on a Makara. Makara is the Vahana of Ganga. She's standing there very elegantly there, and she's holding on to a creeper. Look at the wonderful creeper. Look at the number of parrots that are clinging on to the creeper. Look at the beautiful way they have sculpted out all these parrots on this beautiful vine that she's holding on to her hand. a lovely creation, a beautiful representation of Ganga as the door maiden of this Rajagopura. Right above that Ganga image, you find this being design continued up to the top. And in between the circles, you find wonderful images of Vishnu in different forms being represented. You find here Gopalakrishna, then again seated Vishnu, and so on. Somebody is switched on his mic. Can you unmute it? On either side of the entrance, you have these small images of etched up on either side, which completely represents the Bhagavata Purana. The Purana of Bhagavatam is very beautifully represented in sculptural form on either side of this entrance, main entrance leading into the temple. Look at that. The finale, it's so beautifully done with jalis and that the floral cobbles, all very beautifully done in the typical Vijayanagar style. Now, when you enter into that, you come to the first mantapam, which is known as Purushasupta Mantapam, constructed by the Achyuta Nayaka. A very, very intricately done and beautiful mantapam. You can never see it anywhere. Such a beautiful one, typical in style of Vijayanagar, with the horse and yali pillars all around. There are 12 beautiful such yali pillars, 16 beautiful yali and horse pillars. And all these pillars have beautiful images etched on them. Something phenomenal. It's phenomenal and it's a marvelous beauty that you have to see and enjoy. The Kodungai design of this mantapam is also superbly done. It's done so wonderfully that it surpasses the Audayar Koil, Kodungai. At some places, it surpasses the beauty of the Audayar Koil, and such a beautiful representation of the Kodungai that you see here also. Look at this horse, so beautifully done. This is again, one more horse you find here. Look at the Kodungai, so beautiful Kodungai. And the entire pillars are standing on top of a circumpolary platform, which is raised up to the height of 4 feet. And that's the beauty of this mantapam, Purushasupta mantapam. Look at this. The two legs of the horses are seen here. And there's one warrior fighting a lion here. Another one trying to attack the lion from the top. What a beautiful representation. A fantastic representation of the true Vijayanagar style of the horse pillars. Look at this yali. What a beautiful representative yali. A very intricately designed yali, which is fighting, which is standing on top of a makara and fighting up. And look at the pillar, which is this is a single piece monolithic structure, a pillar, where you find the pillar and the yali all put together in one. And you have the sculptural representation of Mahavishnu as Panapapadanada, and you have Lakshmi Narasimha also here on this pillar. And look at the wonderful Kodungai design also. What intricate work of art. Look at that yali again. A beautiful, another representative in a different yali. A beautiful yali. You have the Mahavishnu with Sridevi and Bhudevi. You have another seated Mahavishnu there, and above that you have Narasimha. All such images are also etched on that. Now you see the detailing of the yali's face. Look at the bulging eyes. Look at the these horns that are coming out like that of a ram. And the designs that are followed on that horn. Look at the mane. Very beautifully done. Look at that rope that goes inside the yali's mouth, and this rider of yali is holding on it. Look at that buckle design, everything. Look at the floral design of the body of the yali, and the one that comes out from its mouth, also the tongue. The yali is made like a floral design. So beautifully executed. Amazing work of art. And from that floral design, it comes out and goes as a sparkle. And inside that emerges a beautiful man, warrior, a Vijayanagar warrior. That's also very beautifully aged. If you see that, this is aged from two sides. On either side, if you go from sea from either side, you'll see the same image there. That's the beauty of this. How beautifully it's been executed. You can see that. The warrior in that. This side also you can see the same warrior. That side also you can see the same warrior. That's the beauty of this. Apart from these pillars, you have very, very slender pillars also sculpted out of the single block of thing. And these pillars are also musical in nature. These pillars also produce musical sounds or metallic sounds. The base on which the entire thing is standing is raised to a height of almost about 3.5 to 4 feet. And it's so beautifully and very intricately done. You can never see such intricate designs in many of the temples. It's something phenomenal. You'll find the row of flowers there, and you find figures of Dwarapalakas and other things, another temple-like projection coming out, and below that you have a beautiful design here, and you find rows of elephants, and this what you see here is rows of parrots. Unfortunately, our people have vandalized the whole thing, and the parrots are broken. What you find here is circle-like thing is, are all parrots. They are all picking down the beaks of lotus flowers. This is supposed to be lotus medallion, and these parrots are picking onto this lotus. And look at the floral design down below at the bottommost line also. It's so very intricately done. Now you can see the parrots very clearly. 90% of the parrots are broken. Only 10% of them are remaining. And on the top, you see the dancers, acrobatic dancers, Bharatanatyam dancers. And you can see the warriors chasing the elephants. And the elephants are going on for a combat or something like that. Gandharvas are also there. Look at this elephant fight. You can see the two warriors behind these elephants trying to motivate them. And look at the dance here. It's happening. It's a typical Vijayanagara style of execution. And you have the parrots there. Almost all the parrots are missing here in this row. Look at that projection, which is made like a mini temple. It's given as a mini temple. And you find the Vishnu image inside that. You find a Vishnu image also inside that. It's projected out as a mini temple with a beautiful Adhishtana, with the Gopura, I mean the Vimana on top. What a beautiful representation of a miniature of the temple. And what sort of designs and imagination has flown through their minds? You find the elephant here. The elephant has got a huge body, but they've skipped the body and given it into the floral design. And similarly, a Makara is seen with the floral tail, totally floral tail. What a beautiful representation for an elephant and a Makara together. Similarly, they've also done this trick with the horse. A horse, the body of the horse is given with the floral tail. What a beautiful way of depiction in this. It's an imagination of the sculptor who has made it. And here you have a Kinnara, the body of a human boy with the floral tail of a swan. You see here, you find the elephants, the Dwarapalas, and so many other images also etched in a miniature form here. And all these carvings, whatever they have done, their sculptural representation, are wonderful workmanship of art. The corners are wonderfully finished with lions and riders on top. And look at the way how it's been finished. Four lions form this whole thing. And they, you have the lion rider. There's a gap between the lion rider and the portion behind also. Such intricate work of art has been executed in them.
Look at the dancing sculpture, the group of dancers there. The dancer along with the musician here, with two yalis on either side, the riders. And the base of the pillar, the yali pillars, there are so many other beautiful representations. Here, the king or the Nayaka is seen dressing himself and tying up his hair to reach the court. And he's been assisted by his wives and other concubines for him to get ready to go to the court. That's beautifully depicted here. And look at the top, the corbel of the pillars. There you find wonderful dancers depicted there on the top. And look at the beautiful design here on the top corbel, which is a lotus medallion. Again, not only this, some erotic sculptures are there representing the Vishnu in the form of Mohini and all these rishis falling for her. The dancers, typical of Vijayanagara style. Again, this is again a typical Vijayanagara style representation of the warriors fighting yalis, lions, the elephants, everything seen here. They are known for their valor. So that has been represented here in this form of sculptural representation everywhere in this temple. And Raghunatha Nayaka and Achyutappa Nayaka, they were very great warriors. So you, no doubt that you see all these sculptures here. Look at that. Elephants, horse riders, everybody is seen on the side of this. On one side, you find the dancers at the lowest bottom place. They're doing this kolatam, and there's a drummer who plays in between for the dance. What a beautiful representation. Again, the miniature temple comes in place here. You find here the image of Rama inside here, Kodanda Rama. In this, the two Gandharvas are there on the top, on either side of this temple. What a beautiful way in which they have executed this. Again, the Vishnu as Mohini and all the rishis behind her. And you have the Nayak, the Tanjavur Nayak in their romantic mood is also being represented here. You see him kissing his wife or maybe a concubine also. Look at the beautiful corbel, how they have finished it. And look at the kudungai, very beautifully done up. And the most important feature of this wonderful Purushottama Mandapam is the roof. The roof is designed such wonderful manner that you have the floral designs running around, and the centerpiece is a beautiful lotus medallion with all the parrots clinging onto the lotus. What a beautiful representation. You find such 12 such beautiful designs on the roof here in this mandapam. Look at that. So beautifully done. Every square has got this wonderful representation of the lotus and the parrots to that. Look at this. This is the lotus medallion. And these are all the parrots that are clinging on to that. Look at the pillars, how beautiful they are. Look at the designs on the rafters of this and the designs everywhere. Very beautiful design, freehand design that you would see on this. Look at that. Amazing way of them. All these are all parrots. And this is the lotus which is blooming up or opening up. Can you make out the parrots very clearly? And this wonderful design on this roof. And the center portion, the lotus just forms as a bud and comes down. And even to that bud, the parrots are seen clinging on to that. What a beautiful representation. Amazing work of art by the Vijayanagara kings in the temple of Sri Mushtamudra. This Purushasapta Mandapam was constructed by Achyuta Panayaka and his son Raghunath Nayaka and his brother-in-law and so on and his viceroys. All their sculptural images are seen here. What you see here is that of the Achyuta Panayaka who built this wonderful temple. He's seen with his two wives here in this one. And these images are made life-size and very natural and with all the designs of the jewelry, the costumes that they wear, it is absolutely a photographic image or a sculptural representation, I would say, of the Nayaks who lived during that period. This is the queen. Look at her. She's standing by one side with the folded hands in Anjali Hasta. Look at her. So beautiful she is. Look at her ornamentation. Look at the ornaments that she's wearing on the head. Look at the ornaments on the ears, the koppu on the ear, the big ear stud, the bhujaharam, the keyuram, and all the kankanas. Look at the number of rings that she's wearing. Look at that megalabharanam. All that she's wearing is amazingly beautiful. Beautiful style of jewelry that she's wearing it. You can see it very closely here. Look at the kankan that she's wearing. Bhujanga, bhujaharam. Look at that band around her hand. Look at the mutyala mala, what she wears. String of pearls. Look at her hairstyle. What a beautiful plate with the kunjalam, everything. So beautifully done. Absolutely realistic. Absolutely realistic. Look at that. So many jada villas that you normally put onto a decoration for your hair, senior. Look at that rock kodi she is wearing. A huge rock kodi. Again, one more ornament here. The jada villa that she wears on this jada. As the jada tapers down, the size of this jada villa also is tapering into smaller size. What beautiful representation of the plates. Amazing. Amazing. Look at her hair. How she is. Look at the kunjal that she's having. Look at her megalabharam. String of pearls that she's wearing around her hip. Look at the dress, the tight-fitting dress that she's wearing. A sari that she's wearing. Tight-fitting. And this is the image of the Raghunatha Nayaka again with his two wives. Look at her. Look at the wonderful way she's wearing a sari. She's even got one sash about her thing, but that is very, very thin, and that's also been shown here very beautifully. Look at the pleats of her sari. Look at the ornaments that she's wearing on the toes, foot toe, and also on the anklets. What a beautiful representation, realistic representation of this lady there. That gives you an insight of how beautifully they were there in those days. Of course, they were fat and buxom, but then they are beauty apart. Look at the different type of hairstyle that she's got. It's not only the plaited hair, but even this type of hairstyle was there in vogue in those days. That also you can see here. Look at her abharanam, megala abharanam. What a beautiful way she's got some waistbands around her. Amazing beauty. And this is again one of the beautiful statues there. Unfortunately, it is broken. People now, even now, they are, I think they will break this hand also in due course of time. When you tap this hand with something hard, you will have a metallic sound. When you tap on his belly, the sound will be just as if you are tapping a rock. So the same rock with which they have made, the granite block which they have made this, producing different types of sounds at different levels. This is an amazing feature, but unfortunately, due to the way the neglect and vandalism, today we have lost this one arm of this Nayaka image here. And this is the Pushkarani inside the temple of Varagaswami. And this is one image that I saw it in this temple, which I till now I'm not able to figure out what it is and what is the Puranic connection with this image. I'm not able to make out at all. Here you see Mahavishnu standing. Normally, right hand he gives the blessing and left hand he shows down. But here it's opposite. And you have the Mahavishnu with this right below the waist. You see Mahavishnu with this form of a cow. And Brahma is seen as the calf. Brahma is seen as the calf down below. I do not know what this forms, and it's something very unusual that I see here. And right behind this temple, there's a beautiful temple dedicated to Shiva, which is called as Nithileshwara temple, and the Devi is Brahannayaki. This is a very old temple of the Chola era, which is there in this temple, very close to this temple. And this temple is a very old temple, and now it is under the protected monument under the ASI. It's a very, very beautiful temple. This is the entrance for the temple and the outer wall of the temple, very close to this. Because of the familiarity and of Guvaraga Swami, people who come there to this Sri Bhushanam visit Guvaraga Swami, and they fail to go to this temple and even see this wonderful temple there of the Chola era there. Sri Bhushanam is an architectural marvel of the Vijayanagar Knights, and it's a landmark of their contribution in the Dravidian architecture. And now we go to the next temple, Ramaswamy Temple at Kumbakonam. Ramaswamy Temple is a prominent Vaishnava temple in the Kumbakonam city, and you have the five-tier Rajagopuram, and it's surrounded by the compound wall all around. This is dedicated to Ramachandra Murthy, who is there seated in the Pattabhishek Kolam of this temple. This beautiful temple was again built by 16th century or 17th century by the Nayaks of Tanjavur, who were the rulers of the viceroys under the Vijayanagar kings. Raghunatha Nayaka, the eldest son of Achyutappa Nayaka and the most powerful king of the Tanjavur dynasty, he was the third ruler of the Tanjavur dynasty from 1600 to 1634. And he was noted for his attainments of the Tanjavur to a great prominence in the literature, the field of literature and Carnatic music. Raghunatha Nayaka's contribution to art and culture was something phenomenal during the Nayak period. He is the one who renovated a number of Vaishnava temples, and he is the one who constructed this Ramaswamy temple and also the Saraswati Mahal library in Tanjavur. He was the one who was responsible for the construction of the Rajagopalaswamy temple at Mannargudi, Tiruchere temple of Sharanatha Swami, and so many other Vaishnava temples. He was a great Vaishnava, and he constructed a lot of Vaishnava temples and renovated the Chakrapani, Charangapani temples. All these things were done during the time of Raghunatha Nayaka. Govindappa Dikshita, or Govinda Dikshita, was a scholar, philosopher, statesman, and a museologist. He was the prime minister of Raghunatha Nayaka. He was a Kannadiga belonging to the Hoysala Brahmin community. He served as the prime minister of the Tanjavur region under Raghunatha Nayaka. So he had his headquarters in Patishwaram, and he was a versatile genius, an erudite scholar, composed Arivamsachara Charitram and Sangeeta Sudhanidhi. He is credited with the contributions of the Amman Shrine at the Patishwaran Temple, which is seen with beautiful Yali pillars there. Amazing work of art in Patishwaram. He was the one who was responsible to build this wonderful temple of Ramaswamy under the instructions of Raghunatha Nayaka in Kumbakonam. The sanctum is so huge, housing the entire Rama Pattabhishekam. Rama and Sita are seated as the king and the queen of Ayodhya on a beautiful throne. Bharata is holding the umbrella above Rama. Lakshmana and Shatrughna flank on the either side. Hanuman is seated below. Unlike Hanuman, who's seated below with the Anjali Hasta, in normally in all the Rama temples, here he is seen playing tambura and holding manuscripts in his one hand. And it is said that he is chanting Ramanama, or rather singing Ramanama. This is the sanctum of Ramaswami temple. The Ramamurti inside there, along with Sita Devi seated on the pedestal, is over 10 feet tall. The images of Bharata, Shatrughna, and Lakshmana are almost about 7-8 feet high, and they flank on either side. All these huge images accommodate inside the sanctum, and the sanctum is so huge, and the Utsav Murti is right kept in the front of that. So it is from one side, you will have to look into that to see the entire images that are inside the sanctum. You can never have the entire image. That's why I showed you the photograph to get a glimpse of how it looks inside. This is a very unique feature of having the entire Pattabhishekam inside the sanctum. No other temple in this country has such a sanctum with all the images of Rama Parivar inside that. And this is the only such temple. You have the entire Rama Parivar inside the sanctum. This is the Utsav Murti of Kodanda Ramaswamy with Lakshmana and Sita. Look at the beautiful image of Kodanda Ramaswamy, Utsava Murti of this Ramaswamy temple. This is the sanctum, and right above the sanctum is the huge Vimana. All the beautiful idols are installed inside this huge sanctum. There's a Mukhamandapam in front with a white Mukhamandapam and total granite structure with a stucco Vimana on top. A closed prakara goes around this first enclosure, and this forms the part of the inner prakara. And this inner prakara is supported by the compound wall of the one side and pillars on the other side. And a closed prakara is enclosed along the three sides of this first prakara. On the walls of this prakara, were plastered, and the entire Ramayana was painted the typical Vijayanagar mural style in three rows. So a person who goes on a three pradakshina can read the entire Ramayana in pictorial form and come back. So the entire wall was plastered, painted beautifully in Vijayanagar style in those days. Unfortunately, the whole thing has gone for a six, improper maintenance, lot of vandalism, everything is gone. Adding fury to this, the HRNC department had organized this contract to some local, banner painter or somebody, and have painted the entire Ramayana there. This is such a horrible sight to see. Garish colors, very uglily presented, and it is a total disaster that they have created. Unfortunately, nobody has taken steps to restore this, nor take it up to their department to see something has been restored. God willing, something happens in the near future. And this is the main mantapa, Maha Mantapa, with 64 pillars. And all the 64 pillars are masterpieces of Vijayanagar architecture in this temple. They are all huge monolithic pillars with sculptural representation on all the four sides. Look at those pillars. This is one of the pillars where you find one lady standing here, and right above that, Krishna is seen in a dancing pose. And this pillar is a representative of Krishna. Now Krishna is seen here. He has put his arm around his Rukmani. So Rukmani is pleased that Krishna is in love with her. But one hand of Krishna is gone to reach his other wife, Satyabhama. So Rukmani cannot see Satyabhama and Satyabhama cannot see Krishna, Rukmani. So Krishna is playing the beautiful game between his two wives. That's how it's beautifully represented here in this wonderful pillar. This is a single pillar, a monolithic pillar. So the three sides, you have the figures here. You can see the huge size of the pillars. And this Venugopala in one of the sides of the pillars. This is again the representation of Ganga in one of these pillars. Here you find Devi Sita and Hanuman on one of the pillars. A beautiful representation of Sita and Hanuman. Look at that Sita. How beautifully she's being represented. The very normal form. She's holding a lotus flower. Look at her hairstyle. It's very, very similar to that of the night style of Kuppu. And look at the beautiful Prabha Mandala around her. The jewelry on her. She's put a shesh around that. That's a very thin thing which is going around. Look at a sari, very beautifully draped up. What a beautiful representation of Sita here and Hanuman on one side. This is a very rare representation that you see here is of Sugriva Pattabhishekam. Sugriva was made the king of Kishkindha by Lakshmana. Lakshmana does the Sugriva Pattabhishekam. Sugriva's wife Tara is seen here. Here you find Jambavan, Angada and others also there. All the Ramayana sculptures are there. This is again the Dwarapalaka senior. This is again a Vishnu Murti who's done this Abhishega. He's seated on his Seshanaga and one side Shiva and other side Brahma are doing the Abhishega for Vishnu. This is again Rama in one of the pillars seen flanked with the Lakshmana and Vibhishana. This is again the image of Jambavan, the bare-faced Kishkindha. He's seen Jambavan from his senior. 1 minute.
Hey, stop taking that.
Sorry. And this side, you have another beautiful image of a lady here. All these pillars are so beautifully. Here you find one Rishi also there. Look at this. Again, a beautiful representation of Trivikrama. Look at that Trivikrama representation here. Mahabali Chakravarti is seen here with his wife. And son here, Namuchi. Here, Mahavishnu is seen as Vamanavatara. Sukracharya is seen here. Mahavishnu is giving his, taking the dana from Mahabali and takes the Trivikrama force. Avatar there. Trivikrama avatar is seen here. Wonderful here represented. Again, Krishna. Image of Krishna. As Gopasri Vastrapaharana, he takes away all the clothes of the Gopastris and goes up to the top of the tree, and that's represented in one of the pillars. Look at that, Rama and Sita in the marriage. Rama is holding very gently the hand of Sita and is the Panigrahana. Again, Rama. This side you have Lakshmana and this side you have Vibhishana. They are doing the mantra lachuna before the Ravana Samhara. Again, one of the beautiful images of the lady is there. And this is again a very rare sculpture that you see here is Rama and Sita and Lakshmana and all the others are here. Rishis and the Munis are all there. This is Rama in Vyakarana Mudra. That is, he is giving Upadesa to all. So Rama and Vyakarana Mudra, or rather Upadesha Kola, is a very beautiful and a rare sculpture that we see here. And that's what you see here. And again, this is the same thing. And one pillar is amazing pillar. On either side of this pillar, the three sides, you have Rama, Lakshmana, and Sita. Rama is a beautiful Rama. One side you have Sita Devi, a very beautiful representation of Sita Devi. Hello, somebody has to mute it. Another beautiful representation of the pillar, it's Sita Devi. And opposite that, you have Hanuman. And on the third side, you have Lakshmana. What a beautiful representation of the Rama, Lakshmana, and Sita in one single pillar. And right opposite to that is Hanuman. And this is a very, very rare sculpture of Rama in this sort of a posture. We have never seen it anywhere in this temple or any other temples rather. Rama and Sita in a very intimate posture, or Shringara Rasa. Rama is gently holding the breasts of Sita and hugging onto her. And this is a very, very Shringara Rasa, which is represented of Rama and Sita in this wonderful temple of Kodand Ramaswamy in Kumbakonam. Look at this, Apsaras playing the Veena. Another Apsara is seeing here. Look at that. Look at this Apsara. How beautiful she is. Look at the ornaments that has been adorned on her head. And look at the ornaments that she's wearing on her hair. The earring. The number of ornaments around her neck. Look at the strands of hair which she has tied as her kuppu. Look at the sash that goes, a very thin sash. Look at the armlet, whatever she's wearing. Amazing. Look at the sharp features of her face. Look at the sharp nose, broad, wide open eyes, the smile on her face, the gentle smile on her face. It's an amazing creation. Look at the dress that she wears. And all the ornaments that she wears, it's amazing beauty. Another dancer. Look at the eyes. Look at the jewelry that she wears. Amazing. Look at the intricate workmanship. Look at the strands of hair that she has tied out of the palm. And the way of which she has arranged the flower around that. Look at the style of flower that she has arranged on her headdress. Amazing beauty. Usual Vijayanagar horse riders, pillars are also there, but they are not so very good compared to the other places. Gajendra Moksham. Here, Gajendra Moksham is different in a different form. Vishnu is seen blessing Gajendra, the elephant. Tumburu and Narada are singing praise of Vishnu for having done the Gajendra Moksham. And here you see Vishnu seated on top of Garuda. Lakshmi Narasimha, again a beautiful representation of Lakshmi Narasimha. People have applied all sort of turmeric and kumkum on that and really spoiled this image. And of course you have Trivenkata Nada. That is Venkatachalapati with his two concerts. Sri Devi and Guru Devi are here. And you have again the Rama, again in the Vyakarana Mudra. He doesn't hold any weapons, but he is giving the Vyakarana Mudra and also holding a flower in his hand. That is the Upadesha Kola. When he is doing this Upadesha, Lakshmana is listening to it. And Hanuman, as usual, is playing his monkey tricks. But when he hears this wonderful message of Rama, he comes and falls at the feet of Rama and surrenders himself. That is what is explained in this wonderful sculpture of Rama seated in Vyakarana Mudra. And this is the Chakrat Alvar that you see here. The great Vijayanagar Empire under the viceroys and Naiks of Tanjavur have built very, very beautiful temples. The Sri Mushnam and Ramaswamy temples are outstanding testimony of the great love of art and architecture. This is my small tribute to these great Vijayanagar rulers and the great unknown Stapatis who created them. Thank you. Any questions? I'm prepared to take.
Thank you so much, sir. It was pure delight as always.